Hey, this is Wes with Missouri Wind and Solar. Thanks for grabbing our YouTube video today. Today's video is about our new Denrail DC timer. So the interesting thing about this is it can take up 20 amps at 24 volts. And we're gonna hook this up today and show you all the good things that you can do with that. Before you get excited about where's Jeff, we always get that question in the comments. He's currently learning throat singing and yodeling in Chile. So he's really, again, enjoying his retirement. Check out his YouTube channel. He's got a wood carving channel now. He's doing some really neat stuff there, so we'll add that down in the comments. But we're gonna move over to the workbench and we'll show you how to hook this up and the cool things that you can do with it. I got my stuff laid out here to kind of show you how this comes together. We've got our 12-24 volt DC timer. It's on a Denrail. It makes it real convenient for wherever you want to mount or anything like that. We've had this specially made for Missouri Wind and Solar. You can get 12 volt timers on Amazon, eBay, all over creation, but we went out and actually had this made for us because we've got a lot of instances where you need that higher voltage, like if you're doing a water heating element in a stock tank or anything like that, those 12 volt timers just can't do it. So we actually went to our supplier and had this made. So this is a really cool device that you can only get here at Missouri Wind and Solar. I've got a 12 volt Northstar AGM battery here that we're using to power this whole thing today. These are great batteries. This is probably our top seller that we bring through here. That's a lot different than just a normal lead acid battery. If you want to learn about that, catch us on the podcast. We do a lot of podcasting on batteries and differences. And then I've got our LED floodlight. These are awesome. They will, I gotta make sure that I don't blind myself while I'm doing this video today as we walk through it. So I wanna walk through how this is wired. Our sales tech, Sam, is actually he's the one that told us to get this done because he needed it. And so he has hooked this up and he's like, hey, let me show you how to hook this up because it can be challenging to follow in the actual instructions. So it's one of the reasons we wanted to do this video. So the way we've got this configured, if you look at the DC timer, what our first connections are is up to the battery. And it's pretty simple, is that you've got L is line, N is neutral. So as you can see here, I've got my red and black cable, and I've just got an alligator clamped up here on the AGM. So that's pretty simple. You connect those up and you're ready to roll. Now, down here on the actual timed side, you can see over here, we've got COM, which is common, and then we've got normally closed and normally open. So what that means, basically all it means is that these two switches here are doing the exact opposite of each other. So whenever it's, if you want something and you hooked it up wrong and your light or your heater's coming on and you don't want it to, you can either reprogram it or really just switch the wires because whenever one's open, the other one's closed. So, now our common wire here, I've got it just laying off over here to the side because I'm going to hook that up to the battery in just a moment. And we don't want to do that yet because there's actually some functions that come on in the timer and wanted to show you how that happens. And then my normally open, again, we've got another hot wire over here. It's just run into the positive on my device, whatever, and in this case, it's this LED flood. And then my negative on my LED flood is sitting right here, and we're gonna put that back on the battery. So your negative side is just basically running over here like that. Now, when I hook these up, we're gonna get some display up here to begin with, so I'm gonna pop this open, okay? And then I'm gonna go ahead and connect this up. So my negative's connected. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hop on my positive. Now, this is the thing that Sam told us, hey, you really need to know this because the instructions, it may not be entirely clear. The big thing that needs to happen when you first hook this up is there's this reset button right here. I'm gonna just use my little screwdriver, but you use a toothpick or something like that. You need to hold that, and that's what's gonna energize this unit to begin with. And you see my display's coming on. I'm not gonna go through all the programming that you can do with this. Obviously it's a timer, it can do all these things, but we're gonna play around with it and see if we can actually kick the light off. And Wow, that's okay. Stop. So that is, that's exactly what it's programmed to do. So I think I may have even got a tan through my shirt here. But that's our 12, 24 volt DC timer. We also sell just a regular 12 volt one too. You can pick up anywhere, but this is really a great product for any of the higher voltage processes that you need. So I'm Wes with Missouri Wind and Solar. Thanks for checking out this video, and we'll keep bringing you some more videos.